And every time it rains, and it's from heaven. Show me to me. Don't you know each cloud contains banners from heaven? Show me to me. You'll find your fortune falling all over town. Be sure that your umbrella is up, upside down.
Way up.
Trading for a package of sunshine and ravioli.
Ravioli!
If you want the thing you love, you must have a pizza only, baby. And when you hit the knock, don't run under a tree.
Pennies better for you and me. Let me tell something. Let me tell all of you something. Only a real man can wear an apron and get away with it. Listen, I'm into equal opportunity comedy. And what's more, I'm tired, so tired of people coming and referring to my age. Hey, for an old guy, you look good. Fuck you very much. How's that? You know, do I fucking come around and shake your tree? No! Me.
And you'll find your fortune falling all over town. Pennies from heaven. Pennies from heaven. Pennies from heaven.
You are me. All right. Okay. I'm tired of people fucking with my head, too. You know what I mean? Fuck it, man. Fuck it! Fuck it! If you don't like me, then get the fuck out of my face! Alright? Karl Jenkins, in these stories, in these stones, horizons sing! In these stones, horizons sing! Gawain 687, my good friend. Now, let me share something with you and get. I, Oba, will speak now. Oba means king, but you just don't get what type of king I am, do you? The time has come for me to reveal myself. Welcome to the dawn of the new eon, where the individual reigns supreme. My uncle Alistair Crowley said, in the new eon, each man will be king. And every woman, beyond a king, beyond even a queen, a goddess. Oh, Nuit, Nuit, my sweet Nuit. Let me kiss you under the azure skies.
Alistair, the much maligned Alistair Crowley, realized that the biggest battle to be fought in this war of true individualism would be over sex. Yes, sex. Yes, the sexual impulse. The sexual confusion that plagues us so. The hang-ups that we have. How am I not a man if I wear an apron? I say pooey, and I spit upon your crapulous creeds. Mankind must learn that the sexual instinct, Crowley says, is in its true nature ennobling. The shocking evils which we all deplore are principally due to the perversions produced by suppressions. Why, in the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says to his cousin Arjun, he says, "Oh, son of Kunti, nothing can be accomplished by repression. The feeling that is shameful and the sense of sin causes concealment, which is ignoble." To say the least. And internal conflict, which creates distortion, neurosis, always ends in an explosion. And by explosion, I am not talking about orgasm, you fools! We deliberately produce an abscess and wonder why it is full of pus instead of cum juice. Why it hurts, but it doesn't hurt good, it hurts bad. Why it bursts in stench and corruption instead of bursting in nectarian bliss. When other physical appetites are treated in this way, we find the same phenomenon. Persuade a man that hunger is wicked. We find, that this is wrong, right? Prevent him satisfying his hunger by eating whatever food suits him best, and he soon becomes a crazy and dangerous brute. Murder, robbery, sedition, and meaner crimes can only come of the suppression of the bodily need for nourishment. People, please, just try to understand, just try to overstand, just try to inner fucking stand already. Oh! The sacrifices that I perform. I must take shelter of the Gita, where it says, be alike in praise and blame. Be alike in gain or loss. Be happy just pulling out a cow's teat. And rolling around in the dust of the fields. The book of the law solves the sexual problem completely. Each individual has an absolute right to satisfy his sexual, her sexual instinct, as is physiologically proper to him or her. All right, stop it. Stop this nonsense, please. The one injunction, however, is to treat, and this is important, to treat all such acts as sacraments. One should not eat as the brutes, but in order to enable one to do one's will, have your fill, if it be your true will. Even though I quiver, I try to keep still. Hush, my darling. Don't make me rush. My sweet muffin of my... nether fantasies. We must use every faculty to further the one object of our existence. The sexual instinct, thus freed from its bonds, will no more be liable to assume monstrous shapes. And if I knew that I would not lose my channel, I would just right now strip naked for all to see my Willy Wonka. But I shan't, because I'm surrounded by a bunch of deviants. Tit squeezers! But if we embrace, if you embrace your own linga, and women, if you embrace your own yoni, and if we just get this orgy started already, perversion will become as rare as the freaks in a dime museum. You know what? I'm getting tired of this bullshit, but I still do it because I am filled with so much tantric love. Just try to feel my bliss. Kiss, kiss. Hiss, hiss. Please play with my afro. Girls.